You've guessed it, guys. Today we are developing color film. It's the first time for me, but I'm sure it'll be all right. I ordered this kit a few weeks ago and I can't wait to try it and see how it looks like when you develop your own color film at home. This one is the liquid kit, but it also exists in powder, but yeah, just went for the liquid one. In total, you can prepare 2.5 liters of developer and all the chemicals you need for the process, and you can develop up to 20, from 20 to 45 film with this kit, so it can help you to save a lot of money on your development cost. So let's go! So this guy comes with 6 bottles. I'm gonna show you quickly what they are for. So this one is the stabilizer. This one is from the developer, so part 3. Developer part 2 and developer part 1. So we're gonna mix those 3 to create the developer and with a bit of water. And these 2 guys are from the bleach and fixer. It's called Blix. So 2 parts here and a bit of water, and the 3rd one is the stabilizer, just a bit of water with this guy and we are sorted. Okay, so let's get rid of this. Today we are going for the 1 liter solution. So I've highlighted here the quantities we have to mix for each of them. So we're gonna start with the developer first. A few things you need to know before you start. The temperature of the water you're gonna use for the chemicals needs to be between 20 and 45 degrees. Ideally, it has to be around 30 degrees. It's gonna make my life easier when we're gonna develop, because developing color film can be a bit tricky because you have to be really precise on the temperature, especially for the developer. You have to be between 29.5 and 30.5 degrees. No more, no less. So you have to be careful, guys. Okay, let's get started. I prepared 3 bottles. I've put numbers on them to make it easier to remind the order, but it's pretty straightforward. We have the first the developer, then the Blix, and the last one the stabilizer. So for now, we're gonna keep only the developer and we're gonna prepare the solution. So first thing we need is 400 millimeters of water, so let's start with that. Okay, so 400 here. Okay, so the second thing we need is 200 millimeters of part 1, the same for part 2 and the same for part 3. In total it will make 1 liter of preparation. Like I'm in Breaking Bad. And that's it, developer's ready. So here we need 600 millimeters of water. This one looks nasty. Doesn't smell too bad for now. Ooh. Thank you. another one done. Last one is the stabilizer, but I only have two funnels and I don't want to mix the chemicals, so I'm gonna have to wash this one to make sure that there is no mix between the developer of the PLX and the stabilizer. So I'll be right back. Okay, the funnel is just out of the shower, so last step is the stabilizer. Very easy. Here we need 800 millimeters of water and the rest of the stabilizer. And that's it guys, simple as that. Our chemicals are ready, we can now develop our color film. Our temperature is at 31 degrees, so it's perfect. I'm gonna let the developer and the Blix sit inside the water, just to make sure that we maintain the correct temperature. Meanwhile, we're gonna load the film onto the rim and get it ready to develop. Okay, so the films are now in the developing tank, so we are ready to rock. So our developer is at the right temperature now, so I'm gonna put it inside the tank and let it sit for 8 minutes. It's not mentioned on the instruction if you have to do inversion or anything like that, so I'm gonna do it the same way like I would do with black and white. I'm gonna do 1 minute agitation at the beginning and then 4 inversion at the beginning of every minute. So let's go. Okay, we're almost done with the 6 minutes. I'm gonna take out the Blix a bit before because I forgot to start the timer, so I think we are good now. I really should be wearing gloves, this is disgusting. I think this film is clean now. It's been 6 minutes that I've been putting clear water inside. So last step now is the stabilizer. And then we can see if we have images inside. It worked. Now we'll have to scan those images to see if the colors are good, but at least there is something. Oh man, that was stressful, this color developing. I prefer black and white, definitely. Okay.